Hello everyone and welcome to the Yin Yoga with Matt YouTube channel. And today I wanted to take a little moment to talk about myself. Last year in 2019, I lost my dad through suicide, and it's been a very rough year for me. So this is what drawn me to start doing yoga. And for myself, Yin Yoga has been a great way to combine mind, spirit, and body. And it really allowed me to meditate and to reconnect with my inner self, which was amazing throughout 2019. I really needed that. So today we're going to do my first Yin Yoga class. Hopefully you're going to like it. We're going to focus on the hips and the lower back. And it's designed to increase flexibility throughout your body. So a bit of my background, I'm an ex-military and I've been in the army for 8 years. And when I got out of the army, I joined correctional services and I did that for 2. I am now working for the private, a private department in the government doing security, and Yin Yoga has been a great way for me to increase my flexibility, especially with the long hours that I might do doing surveillance seated, and it's been really amazing. It's been life-changing. So I hope you're going to love this practice as much as I do. And without any further ado, let's get into my first class that I'm going to teach with the help of my sister, Miriam. All right, see you there. Ciao. Hi yogis and welcome for joining us on this beautiful Yin Yoga sequence that we're going to do today. This sequence will focus mainly on the hips and back area. And today's theme is going to be about being in the moment. So I really want you to take the time to allow everything around you to disappear and really focus on this practice today. I want to thank you for taking the time to think about yourself and to think about letting go of stress, which is our intention today. There was a nice quote I found, and it was saying that you can't always control what's going on the outside, but you can always control what's going on the inside. So today, I want you to take that quote with you, incorporate it into your lifestyle, and really take the time to relax and let go of all stress, all worries, anxiety, tension, and everything that's occupying your mind at the moment. So starting off, we're gonna start with a 10-minute meditation. So I want you to assume the lotus position. So today we have Miriam, she's gonna be my student. For those of you who don't know what the lotus position is that you're going to take your right foot and put it over your left thigh and your left foot over your right thigh. Now, maybe those of you cannot do this at the moment, so it's okay if you put them one in front of the other. And we're going to start with the Ujjayi breath. The Ujjayi breath is a breathing technique that you utilize to warm up your body. So it's going to be part of our warm up. And as you breathe in, with every exhale, you're going to make a sound. So we're going to start breathing in. Breathe out. Once more, you're going to breathe in. Breathe out. And with every exhale, I want you to focus, like I said, on letting go of stress, letting go of any tension in your body, and really take the moment to allow your body to warm up for this beautiful practice that's going to follow up next. As you do the breathing technique, I want you to place your hands in the Dhyana Mudra position. So the Dhyana Mudra is the way that you place your hands, and it's supposed to enhance concentration. It's especially useful while doing meditation. So if you look at Miriam, she has left hand over the right hand. You join your thumb right in front of you, resting on your lap, and you keep breathing in and out. Breathe
Today's yin yoga practice, for those of you who haven't done yin yoga practice, and for Miriam, it's her first day doing a yin yoga practice. Yin yoga is about allowing gravity to do the work for you. So throughout the practice that's gonna follow, I want you to really allow your body in each position to work with gravity, meaning I don't want you to strain yourself or force anything. In yin yoga, we hold positions for somewhere around 5 minutes to sometimes a bit more. And it's really meant to allow your fascia and your joint tissues to stretch. So it's a really good complementary exercise if you're a very active person, an athlete, somebody who does all sort of sports, for you to gain flexibility. Keep breathing in and out. One of the challenges of yin yoga is to hold position, and you're holding them still, which means that for a lot of people, especially in today's day and age with our fast-paced lifestyle, it's very hard to take the time to really do nothing. And that's one of the challenges of yin yoga, holding positions for a certain period of time, really connects you with your inside and ultimately with your soul. And it's as well a form of meditation. So that's something that's very challenging. But hopefully with time, as you get a better understanding of the practice, you're gonna become more and more comfortable with slowing down and allowing yin yoga to be your moment of peace. We're gonna stay for another 4 minutes. Also, in today's practice, if you have any form of injury, I want you to notice that maybe certain movement or certain position we'll be doing today might be putting some stress on your injury. So I want you to listen to your body and really be aware that it should be challenging, but it shouldn't hurt. And if it hurts, it's okay to back off or back out of the position and to wait for the next one. So really take your time and don't stress over it. It's all about working with your own body and limitation and gravity. Gonna stay in here for another 2 minutes. And as you keep using the Ujjayi breath technique, you're gonna notice that your body gets warmer and warmer in preparation for the following sequence. If you are familiar with meditation, one of the goals is to empty your mind. So I want you during this last minute of the meditation to really focus on releasing all your thoughts. Everything that you might have been going through today that has been negative, that hasn't been a positive experience for you, just let go of that and leave it where it belongs so that you can really focus on your health and taking this moment for you because you deserve it. You can open your eyes and slowly coming out of the lotus position, we're going to do a quick warm up. So I want you to assume child's pose. So coming on your knees, you're gonna bring your buttocks to your heels and lean forward for 30 seconds. Extend your hands in front of you. You can open your knees wider if you want a more challenging position for your hips, and especially inner groin. And just allow yourself to get closer to the floor. If you can put your forehead on the mat, that's great. And just feel the stretch throughout your body. We're gonna stay here for 30 seconds. You can slowly come out of the position and get back on all fours. We're gonna move to a cat and cow position. So from all fours, keeping your knees right under your hips and your shoulders right under your wrist, you're gonna extend your body backwards, meaning you're gonna extend it, you know, upwards, rounding your back, and as you exhale, you're gonna lift your head up and allow your belly button to move towards the ground, really feeling a deep stretch in your spine. Taking a breath in, round your spine up, push through your shoulder blades, extend your back, and out, stretch again, backward. Once more, inhale, round your back, and as you exhale, allow yourself to stretch backwards. From this position, coming back to a neutral spine, you're gonna put your foot down and do a downward facing dog. So coming on your sole of your feet, extend through your arms, lift your hips up towards the sky, and press through your hands, moving your body backwards, as Miriam is doing right now. If you have a lot of tension behind your legs, you can bend your knees. And just go with a stretch, 30 second stretch in this position. Now coming out slowly of the position, you can bring your knees down to the floor and take a seated position. We're gonna start our Yin Yoga sequence. Now for this sequence, I recommend you use blocks. There is maybe certain limitation or positions that are more challenging. So if you have two blocks, keep them handy beside your mat. They might be useful at some point, and I'll show you how to use them as we go through position. So our first position is the butterfly position. So bring the sole of your feet in front of you, sitting down. You're gonna allow yourself to lean forward from the trunk and slide your hand slowly but surely forward as you allow your back to be round if you want and work with gravity to really stretch your inner groin, hips, and spine. If you want a more challenging position, you can bring the soil of your feet closer to your groin. Now Miriam's maybe not gonna do it, or she will, but this brings more stress in your inner thigh. Also, in this position, you can use blocks to put them behind your knees, right under your knees, as I will demonstrate here, and putting them on each side will allow you to be more comfortable throughout the position. We're gonna hold this for 5 minutes. Now it's important that you ease yourself into each position, as well as easing yourself out once we're gonna be coming towards the end. If at any point you're feeling any pain, feel free to back out of the position or maybe take a few steps back until you find your point of limitation. For those of you who are not familiar with yin yoga, it's normal that you're gonna feel some kind of stretch in different direction and a different part of your body. As long as it doesn't hurt or you're not experiencing a sharp pain, this is all normal, and that's the idea of the practice, to increase your flexibility. So just work with it. Now with every breath in, as you exhale, I want you to really feel the release of the tension throughout your body, muscle, joints. And with every exhale, maybe you'll notice that your flexibility increases. Maybe not, but that's okay. If you can walk your hands a little more forward, go for it. If not, just hold the position as you are right now. I'm gonna stay here for another minute. Now, as you're coming out of the position, slowly walk your hands backwards, very gently. Don't force anything. Staying in position for this amount of time will sometimes hurt if you walk out of it too quick. So now you can move the blocks away from your knees. And we're gonna do the second position, the caterpillar position. So extend your legs in front of you. If you can have them straight, that's perfect. If your hamstrings are a little tight, you can bend your knees. And I want you to bring your hands forward. It can be along your foot or in between. That doesn't really matter. The idea is to feel a stretch behind your legs and throughout your spine. So we're gonna hold this position for 5 minutes. As I said earlier, just work with gravity and you have 5 minutes, so not force anything. You will notice that you'll gain flexibility as time passes. So try to notice the sensation in your body. If you can notice any specific tension, like I said, with every breath, try to focus on the exhale, on releasing the tension from that area more and more. And as you release tension out of your tight body and muscle and joints, you're releasing as well stress, accumulated stress from your day or from your week. As you can see, Miriam is slowly walking her hands more forward, which means that her flexibility is increasing. Now you can walk your hands backwards slowly and come back up to a neutral spine. You can wiggle your legs a little bit to loosen up and get the blood flowing. You're gonna come on your knees for child pose. So we did it earlier, but now we're gonna do it yin yoga style for another 5 minutes. So opening your knees as wide as you comfortably can, you're gonna join your big toes together behind, and you're gonna bring your buttocks towards your heels. And as you can see with Miriam, you're gonna move your hands forward. And if you can bring your forehead to the ground, that's great enough. If not, you can always bring a block so you can rest your forehead on it. At first, you'll notice that this is not a very challenging position, but the more you stay into it, the more you're gonna start feeling a deep stretch in your inner groin area. And that's what we're trying to do here with this position, increasing your hips flexibility. For those of you that work desk jobs, a lot of times your hips will get very tight from staying seated for long hours. So yin yoga is a great way to bring back flexibility, and those tight hips will, which ultimately will improve your health and get your prana to flow better throughout your body. Prana meaning your life energy. remember to breathe in slowly and to exhale slowly as well. Everything in Yin Yoga is slow. It doesn't make it any easier. It just means that I want you to really take the time to do everything very slowly. We're staying in here for another 2 minutes, minute and a half. Another 30 seconds. Now you can slowly come out of it and walk your hips forward to all fours. We're going to set ourselves up for dragon pose, which is our next position. So keeping your hands and shoulders aligned and your hips over your knees, you're going to step your right foot forward in between your hands. And this is sort of a deep lunge. You're going to keep your left foot extended as much as you can and push your hips forward and down, but keeping your knee aligned with your foot. So try not to pass too far in front so you don't hurt your knee. Now this is where you can use your block to support yourself. So you can put your hands on each one and you extend your back and backwards and your hips forward to really work with gravity and get those tight hip flexors to stretch. Now this is one way of doing the position, but for those of you who are more flexible, you can take the blocks away and either put your forearms on the ground inside of your right leg and hold the position as Miriam is demonstrating right now. And then there's those that are super flexible that can really collapse their body forward and extend their hands in front of them. But we're not gonna go there today. I think that's challenging enough. Now always remember to breathe while you do the positions. This is something that we tend to do whenever we're stretching or experiencing some form of stress throughout our body and our joints or whatnot. We tend to hold up on breath, and this is counterproductive to what we're doing today. So as you do the position, really take the time to breathe at the same speed in and out, and try not to focus too much on the stretch. Allow your body to do its thing. As you can see, it was becoming perhaps maybe too hard for Miriam, so she took a step back and came back to position number one, which is great. That's exactly what I want you guys to do. If it becomes too hard, feel free to back out of it or come back to a more comfortable position. This really isn't any form of competition. You're doing this for you to increase your flexibility, and you're doing this only for you, so don't feel ashamed if you're not flexible at the beginning. With time, you'll get there. All right, you can come out of it slowly, extending your leg straighter and bring it back. Now wiggle your legs a bit, move them around. Do anything that feels comfortable at that point to get the blood flowing before we go to the next side. When you're ready, you can step your left foot in between your hands again, extending your right behind you and moving your hips forward and down while stretching your spine backward. And you don't need to strain your neck, you just want to round your back. Your head can stay in a neutral position. Feel free to, again, to use the blocks if you need to and take them out of the position as you become more comfortable with it. We're going to do another 5 minutes on this side. Now appreciate the feeling of your hips opening up and stretching. With every inch that you are gaining, you're improving your flexibility, which is what we want to do. flexible body is a healthy body. Remember that. We have another 2 minutes to go. Now we're going to be holding this position for another minute. Now moving your hips backwards, come out slowly of the position, bringing your left leg back. Feel free again to move your legs around, your knees, your hips. Do whatever feels good at that moment. And we're gonna set up again on all fours for our next position called the sleeping swan. So stepping up your right leg or your right knee towards your right wrist, creating a perpendicular angle to the front of your mat. You're going to be walking your hands forward, if you can, as far as possible. Now your right foot might create a perpendicular angle to the front of your mat if you're flexible, but it might as well move backwards, and that's okay as well. Just work with whatever you can. This is when you can use your block and put them under your forehead if you want to be resting on something that's more comfortable for your level of flexibility. But if you don't need them and you can bring your forehead all the way to the ground, go for it. We're going to do this side for 5 minutes before we go to the other one. And again, don't forget to breathe. Inhale and exhale. By now, you should already notice a feeling of wellness throughout your body as you're relaxing more and more and letting go. We have about another 2 minutes on this side before we go to the other one. It's okay too if you're not able to bend forward all the way to the floor like Miriam, you can rest your hands on the floor and have your body straight up. Just go as far forward as possible. We have about another 30 seconds. You can now slowly ease out of the position as you walk your hands backwards and get your right leg to go back again. Move your hips around, wiggle your legs, get the blood flowing in that hip. And when ready, you're gonna do the same thing with the left leg. So bringing your left knee to your left wrist, trying to do a perpendicular angle to the front of your mat if possible, and if not, that's okay. You're gonna slowly come forward. Once again, as comfortable as you can use the block for support under your elbows, or you can use your hands to stay in a more upright position. Whatever feels comfortable, but is still challenging at this moment. And as you can see here, I'm just gonna touch you and try to bring your hips more square with the floor. You don't wanna be rolling on the side of your leg. Try to stay square to the floor and keep both hips at the same level on each side. In Yin Yoga, we try to hold the positions for about 5 minutes, because that's the amount of time that it takes for your fascia and your connective tissue to really start stretching so that you can get the benefits of this practice. We have about a minute and a half left on this side. You can start to slowly ease out of the position, walking your hands backwards. Take your time, go very slow. You can bring that leg back again and move your hips around. Now when ready, I want you to lie flat down on your stomach. First sphinx pose. Now you're gonna bring your hands right in front of you and lift your back. And you can walk your elbows closer to being under your shoulder for a more challenging lower back stretch. And as you hold this position, I want you to bring your shoulder blades backwards and down. If you feel any sort of pinch in your lower back, feel free to walk your hands forward again and lean your trunk forward to release some of that tension until you're comfortable again. This is an excellent position to stretch your lower back. And as Miriam is doing, it's important to keep your neck neutral in line with your spine. You don't need to curve it up and backwards and strain your neck. We are stretching the spine, especially the lower back, so no need to overreach your neck up and back. For me personally, I find that this position is really great to release the stress that I might be experiencing throughout the spine. I find it's a very relaxing position that feels good. So embrace it and roll with the feeling. Once again, allow yourself to breathe in and out slowly, as this is what moves energy throughout your body. You don't want to be holding on the breath, as it is counterproductive to this practice. With every exhale, releasing more and more tension throughout your spine. We have about another minute left. Now, to come out of this, you could slowly plant the sole of your feet back on the ground and push through your hands to a downward facing dog, stretching your spine. You can wiggle your legs a bit too. Just do what feels good here before coming all the way down to your back for our next position. Now, this is one of my favorite positions to stretch the side of your ribs and your hips as well, and it's called banana pose. So lifting your hips up and moving them to the right, you're gonna slowly walk your feet towards the left and then extending your arms over your head, grabbing your shoulders, your elbows. You're gonna walk your upper body to the left. Now don't force anything, but as you form this banana shape, you should start feeling a big stretch on your right side all the way down towards your hip. And if you want a bigger stretch and you wanna stretch your IT band, you can cross your right leg over your left, heels over heels, and that should provide a deeper stretch. We're gonna stay in this position for 3 minutes before doing the other side. So try to relax and breathe through the position as you feel your side opening up. For those of you, this might be a new position. It's pretty rare that we stretch the side, and this is why I really like this one. You have another 30 seconds before we move to the other side. Now you can slowly ease out of it by walking your feet and upper body back to a neutral straight line. Now once you achieve a straight line, we're gonna do the other side. So you're gonna lift your hips up towards the ceiling and move them or shift them to the left while slowly walking your feet to the right. And then bringing your arms over your head, grabbing your elbows, you're gonna slowly shift your upper body to the right as well, creating that stretch that you're seeking on your side. And if you wanna hit the IT band, just cross your left leg over your right and rest in that position for 3 minutes. It's also important to try to keep your hips flat with the ground as much as you can. You don't want to lift up and roll towards the right. You just want to stretch your side. We have about another minute in that position. Now you can slowly get out of the position, walk your feet back towards the left and your upper body towards the middle. And we're gonna come through the position called Happy Baby. So for this position, you're gonna bring your knee towards your chest, feet towards the sky, and with each arm, you're gonna grab your big toes. Now the idea is to pull your hips towards you so that you can really feel your inner groin opening However, you don't want to be forcing and straining your arms, as this is supposed to be using gravity mostly. For the rest of your body, keep your body flat on the ground, the back of your head on the mat, and just allow those hips to open and your knees to move more and more down towards the ground. And we're going to stay here for 5 minutes. It's our last position before Savasana. If grabbing your toes is too hard, you can always grab the inside of your foot, which provides a bigger grip and might be easier for certain people. We have about another 2 minutes. Now you can release your foot, your feet, and bring them down. We're gonna come into our last position, Savasana. So extend your feet in front of you, bringing your palms up and your arm by your side. Feel free to open your legs as wide as comfortably possible, and the same with your arms. This is really the time to thank yourself for allowing this special time tonight to join us into this practice of Yin Yoga. Take the time to notice all the changes in your body from when you started to now. Do you notice that you feel perhaps less stress? Do you feel calmer? Do you feel like your energy is flowing better now that you stretch your body? Just really take the time to absorb all the positive energy that you gathered today throughout this practice. And I want you to breathe in and out and focus only on that as you relax and absorb everything you did for yourself today throughout this past hour. Now, for the next minute, I would like you to join me into doing three So we're gonna inhale, and as we exhale, we're gonna release with the sound. So starting now, take a big inhale, release, and do the sound. Allow the vibration to resonate throughout your body. Once again, inhale and exhale. One last one, inhale and exhale. Now you can slowly come out of the position and take a seated lotus position, like the beginning of our sequence. Crossing your legs again above your thigh if you're flexible, or right in front of you if you're not. You're gonna bring both hands in front of you towards your heart, closing your eyes. This is gonna be our last minute, and I really want you to thank yourself. Thank yourself for being this amazing person that you are. Thank yourself for all the positive things that you have to bring to this world. And thank yourself for simply being you, because you are unique and there's no one else like you. All right, guys, well, my name is Matt, and thanks again for joining me and my sister Miriam into this Yin Yoga practice. Until next time, namaste.